have come with your fresh bandages. We've had them laundered and cleansed off, of course. I know that you've been... They replaced your blankets with inadequate substitutions, but I've come with proper ones. Hopefully this accommodates your... sweating and whatnot, and recuperates, or rather, bandages up your wounds. We don't want you dying from your infections now. Has everything been adequate, your stay here? Clean, proper. Great, good to hear. It's good to hear. I'm doing my best to keep this establishment as sanitary as possible. That's what I've noticed, that a lot of the soldiers have been dying from, or the infections caught from the soldiers lying in their own excrement, and from the facility itself being so foul and unclean, and the bandages and the blankets being of filthy quality. It's not doable at all. So, hopefully these new bandages will keep you nice and clean as you recuperate. How have you been feeling lately? Good, good. Are you having difficulty sleeping? A bit. There is a psychologist now that can help you analyze your thoughts and build upon them. Father has been discussing him with his studies. They're both educated men and of high society, so they've been discussing their theories with one another, him being a proprietor of... my father, rather, being a proprietor of the nursing field and of hospitals and whatnot, considering how... I do apologize, I'm rambling on like an old bat, but I'm trying to fold your bandages as best as I can. It's quite difficult holding my lamp while doing this, but... as I was saying, my father has donated large sums of money prior to me even becoming a nurse to hospitals and whatnot, and to the medical care of others, considering how if you're not of wealthy status, then you don't have the luxury of going to a hospital to be taken care of, and even if you do have the wealth to be taken to a hospital for proper care, for proper medical attention, the women there, being nurses and, I mean not nurses, nuns and maids and whatnot, tend to not know what to do. So, of medical need, they often pray over you, as is the responsibility of a nun, or they tend to you and ask you how you're doing, as is the responsibility of a maid, but they don't have any medical knowledge, as I do. Now, I do see that your wound is... give me one moment. I did wash my hands, as is the protocol with women now. I am telling everyone here that if you are going to be working with the patients, wash your hands and cleanse yourself. Let me just check your wound here. It is superficial. It isn't as deep as before. The wound is scabbing over as well, so that is a good sign. I would give it a good week, and it should be quite healed properly. With some time, of course, it'll go back to normal, but here. Let me put down my lamp. It's a bit hot right now, so I am nervous about it, but yeah. Let me put this on. Pass it on. Is it a little too tight? No, perfect. There we go. And just tell me if I fasten it on a little too tight. I'm a bit worried with my lamp that it's gonna incend something, but here. That is a terrible place to put my lamp. It's no wonder people call me Lady with a Lamp. I often get distracted with where to put my lamp as I'm treating patients. There we go. It's clean and it's dry, so that way the infection the water within the bandage doesn't absorb your blood and infection. There we go. So, you should be properly here. I just want to make sure that it's properly secured. Can you feel this? It's still tender. Tell me how that feels. Is it tender? Is it sharp? Is it numb? It's tender. Okay. And I assume if I press it in, I will try. But if I press it in, it'll be sharp. I don't want to cause you pain. This hospital's caused you pain enough and has killed multiple soldiers as a result of their their inconsideration. Now, there we go. Have you already received your meal? Great. I've been securing people's meals so that way they... Your second bandage for your second wound on your neck. So that way they don't... If with proper care, with proper sanitation, and with proper... With a proper diet, that should really solve all the wounded soldiers' needs, because most of the soldiers here are just suffering from wounds. Yeah, simply want to check your bandage a little better. The nighttime has often blocked my view of it. There we go. Okay. And then. There we go. Okay. And how is your cognizance, your perception? How have you been doing with processing information and whatnot? You've been doing all right. I'll be testing that just to assure myself. I want to make sure that every soldier here receives the proper medical attention that they deserve. There might be numerous amounts, but that doesn't mean that an efficient and hard-working nurse can't attend to all of them in the way that they should be attended to. Now, for your second wound, let me warm this up a little bit. Hopefully it provides a little more of a tender care, a tender touch to your neck right there. It is, obviously you can't see your own neck, but it is healing up quite nicely. Also scabbing over, but it is doing better than your head wound. Which is a bit of a surprise, yes. But your head wound was a little more deep than your neck wound. Your neck wound was a bit more superficial. Had it been deeper, that would have been a grave problem, as everyone knows. Now I'm going to be wrapping up your neck. Just tell me if it's a little too tight. It's fine. Great. Now, there we go. And your blanket. Have you received your proper blanket? There is sheets that we offer when we run out of clean blankets that are thin. They're very thin. I know that you have a very thin blanket here. I brought this soft blanket. So that way you have more of a proper tender care. Let me just warm it up a little bit so that way you have a proper warm blanket to keep you well company at night. Often it is love and tender care that helps recuperate people fastest. It brings up their spirits and it helps them to keep in a good frame of mind, keep away the negative thoughts as is. That's why we also give you proper meal made by good-hearted, hard-working women in the kitchen, tending to the men that have sacrificed their time and their, well, were willing to sacrifice their lives for us. And some men have, whether it be on battlefield or in the hospitals, which is something that I'm going to be curtailing as fast and as possible as I can. Okay. Here I'm going to be putting on this blanket now. You can keep the sheet, of course, it's clean. And you can have two sheets at a time, it's okay, we have plenty of those thin sheets. I'm going to tuck you in nice and snug so that way you can recuperate as fast as you can. That way you know that the hospital appreciates your sacrifice and tends to the sick. Now just tell me, is this a little too snug for you? It's perfect. Excellent. Let me simply tuck you in. There we go. Now, I just want to test your cognizance. so that way I know that you're able to, you know, keep in the right frame of mind. I know that some soldiers that I've noticed or that I've picked up a pattern on tend to be a little, they don't tend to be in reality anymore. They tend to wander off and coast off into a different world that they were accustomed to for the past couple of months or years, depending on how long they were in their service. So, with my lamp, which is a bit hot, I just want you to follow the candle with your eyes, just your eyes. I just want to make sure that you have good cognizance and are able to remain within the reality that we are currently in right now. So I want you to look at the candle itself, the wick, and follow it with your eyes. So to the left, and then to the right, and then up and down, and then up and down. Once more, keep your eyes focused on the wick, and then to the bottom right, the bottom left. Excellent, you're doing such a good job. And then to the top left, and then the top right. Excellent, you're doing an excellent job. Now, tell me, how many fingers am I holding up? 3, excellent, and then 4. Excellent. Now, how many fingers am I holding up? 3. Excellent. 2. Excellent. And then? Excellent. You're doing an excellent job. Now, give me one more moment. I brought you a tray of food as well, a little snack as it was. Here, let me just... Some biscuits. I brought you some biscuits from the kitchen. I'm bringing everyone biscuits from the kitchen. I just wrapped them up in this foil to keep them preserved and clean. Open the foil once you are ready to eat it. Don't open it until then, so that way the sick illnesses from the others don't contaminate the food. And if you end up opening it beforehand and someone else ends up, for instance, sneezing or coughing nearby while the package is opened, I would not suggest, in fact I would actually caution you from eating the biscuits. If you'd like some extra ones because those have been contaminated, then of course call either myself or any of the other nurses to provide you with some biscuits. But until then, just keep it enclosed. So I'll be putting the biscuits next to your tray of food right there. And of course, let me just remove the seal that this bottle belongs to someone now. When the seal is broken, the bottle already belongs to someone, so. There we go. And if it belongs to someone, others know not to drink from it. So a good source of hydration. Your body, when you sweat, rather the day or the night, the warm days are coming, so you're going to start sweating sometime, depending on how long you're going to be staying here for. But I wouldn't imagine that you'd stay here very long. Soon enough, you'll have an honorary discharge. But if you end up staying here for longer or whatnot, the body tends to sweat, and when they sweat, water needs to be provided. And if you end up getting exercising, or if you end up doing any sort of exertion of energy, you're going to be needing some water in order to replenish the fluids. Otherwise, you might you don't allow the body the full energy and strength that it needs in order to recuperate from your illness. Now, I'll put it right next to your biscuits. There is a cup of water already provided, but I am also offering the soldiers some extra water in case they need it. You can never have enough water, and you can never have enough sustenance to keep one's body healthy. Now, what's more, I think you're all set when it comes to you. When it comes to the bandages and blankets and whatnot. But right now I'm going to be asking your opinions over the care and your opinion over your stay here in this hospital and how you believe it could be improved. I'm taking any sort of consideration, any opinions that the soldiers might give me in order to better the treatment. Where's my pencil? Put this over here. I'm going to be taking down some notes so that way I can better the quality of your stay here and make sure that the nurses know what standard to take care of the patients with. So, and a blank sheet of paper finally. Now, the date is uncap my feather pen. Florence Nightingale conducted the your name, soldier, please. Thank you. And is there a suffix that goes along with this name? Such as the senior, junior, third, or anything like that? Okay, excellent. And do you have any title to speak of? Such as Lord or Duke or whatnot? Excellent. Now, tell me, how has your stay here been? I simply want to light my words so that way I don't miss a single thing. And would you say that you've received adequate medical attention? And who have been the names of your nurses, if you can recall them? One of them, you can recall one of them. Okay, excellent. And what was the name of that nurse? Excellent. And how is her treatment of your bandages and blankets and your health in general? Excellent. And may I have a summary of your wounds and how they've been progressing throughout your stay here? You were here prior to my arrival. Okay, excellent. And how is the comparison between your wounds progressing then and now? please be as detailed as possible. I don't try and curtail your answers on my behalf. Okay. And overall, how has your, what is your opinion overall as to how my my additions to the medical treatment been improved? How have your opinions over them been in general? Excellent, thank you. And do you have any ideas as to how it could be further improved, or how they could be bettered? Excellent. Okay. Be as thorough as you want, even if you believe that it isn't a possibility or within the realm of reality. Still express yourself, so that way I can get a full note, and that way even if you have an idea that you might think is unrealistic, I can make it realistic within the realm of possibilities. Okay, continue. Do not be abashed, you may express yourself freely. Okay. Alright. Continue. Do you have any further ideas? One more. Okay, excellent. And then what is the one idea that you have left? Excellent. Perfectly alright. Perfectly. Genius, in fact. Excellent. A soldier and a thinker. And do you have any further comments? Okay, a few. Excellent. And is there anything further you'd like to add? No. Excellent. Okay. Let me turn my book away then. Where is the cap? To make another pen. There it is. Okay. There we go. And then let me put my journal aside. You are all set, so I'm going to be simply asking you once more, is there anything else I can help you with? Whether it be your bandages, the blanket, is there any other accommodations I can possibly make to make sure that you're feeling better? No, okay, excellent. Here. If you'd like, for entertainment, I brought you some scratch paper, so that way you can jot down your experiences within the war, or your experiences here, and keep them as your own private journal. As you can see, all the pages are blank, and you can document your own experiences, or if you'd like, you can simply draw on them and make little drawings for yourself. That way it's just a form of entertainment, really. Here we go. Here's a pencil that you can use to, or a feather pen rather, that you can use to make sure that you obviously write. And here is a book in case you'd like to read something while you stay here. That way you're entertained. Obviously, the soldiers have you also entertained with their conversation and whatnot, as is the practice between soldiers. Obviously, you like to converse amongst one another and whatnot. But if you decide that you're all, that you'd rather keep to your own company, or if you are awake during the night, such as now, that you don't have anyone to talk to, you can either draw, write, or read something. Now, if you don't mind, I'm going to be going on to the next patient and assuring that their stay here is as comfortable as yours, as you have expressed. And give me one moment. There we go, it's a bit hot. So once more, I just want to make sure, is your stay here comfortable? Is everything clean and is everything up to standard? It is. Excellent. Now, hopefully you have a good night, and I'm going to be taking care of the next patient. I am the lady with the lamp, as you know.